All right, Ninja Nerds, in this video, we're going to talk about the cross-section of the spinal cord. So we're actually looking at C3 through C6. This is actually the body, so this is the anterior side of the cervical vertebrae. These are the superior articulating processes with facets. And this is the actual bifid spinous process. So this is going to be on the posterior side here. All right, so here we're looking at a cross-section of the spinal cord. So we're just taking a little transverse cut here, and we're looking at it now. So if you look here, since this is the anterior side up here, this is actually the anterior gray horn of the spinal cord. Now, the reason why they call it the gray horn, well, actually kind of looks like a horn here, but on top of that, you have unmyelinated cell bodies here in this anterior or ventral gray horn. And this is actually the cell bodies of the somatic nervous system, so they control your skeletal muscles. If you look here, you have like your little central commissure, and then that little black hole right there is the central canal of the spinal cord. That's where some of the cerebrospinal fluid runs through. This right here is the posterior gray horn of the spinal cord. Okay, and it's actually consisting of cell bodies that pick up peripheral sensations. We'll talk about that when we talk about ascending tracts. Other things, we could talk about the white columns real quick. This is all the anterior white column over here, anterior white column right there. So they actually carry specifically crude touch and pressure. All over here is actually going to be the lateral white column. Over here is lateral white column. They actually carry pain and temperature pathways. And then back here is the dorsal white column, and that actually picks up proprioception and fine and discriminative touch. Okay, so now that we talked about the cross-section of the spinal cord, let's actually look at some of the layers surrounding it. This is the main thing we're going to talk about. So if you look here, we can see this blue connective tissue here clinging right to the spinal cord. That blue connective tissue that's directly clinging to the spinal cord is called the pia mater. Okay, the pia mater. Then if you look, there's a space right here, sitting right in here, this whole little space. That space is called the subarachnoid space. That's where your cerebrospinal fluid runs through, okay? Then if you look here, we gotta be really, really meticulous here. If you see this little brown like line going all the way around, guys, that brown line is actually called the subdural space. Now, on this side, closer to the spinal cord, there's a blue line, this blue layer here. There's a blue layer on this side, closer to the spinal cord, on this side of that brown line. That blue tissue on this side is called the arachnoid mater. So on this side of the brown line, closer to the spinal cord, lining this part is the arachnoid mater. And this over here would be arachnoid mater. Again, on this side of the blue, the brown line. Again, that brown line right there is going to be the subdural space. Okay, that's where some certain amounts of blood vessels and, bridging veins can actually be found. Okay? So again, you have subdural space. On this side of the subdural space is the arachnoid mater. On this side, closer to the actual bone, this side, this is the actual meningeal layer of the dura mater. Okay, so inside is the arachnoid mater. Outside is going to be the meningeal layer of the dura mater. Then you have this space right here. This space right here, which contains fat and some blood vessels, is actually going to be called the epidural space, okay? And then this is actually going to be the outer periosteal layer of the dura mater. So this is the periosteal layer of the dura mater, this blue structure here. It's what clings to the bone. Okay, so recap real quick. Pia mater, subarachnoid space is the space with the CSF. This blue connective tissue that's actually going to be coming in contact with the cerebrospinal fluid in the space, this blue connective tissue on this side of that brown line is the arachnoid mater. That little brown beige line is the subdural space. This blue tissue right here is the meningeal layer of the dura mater, and it's on the outside of that brown line closer to the bone, this one right here. This is the epidural space, which is containing some fat, right? And it's going to have some blood vessels in there. And this is the periosteal layer of the dura mater. Okay, now that we covered that, I just want to show you basically two other structures. I'm going to turn this actual cross section around. All right, engineers, so what we're going to do is we're going to look at a couple other extra structures on this cross section on the anterior side. If you look here, you see these arteries right here, right? This is actually going to be the vertebral arteries, and they're actually running up through this little space here. Remember that hole? It's called the transverse foramen. Well, these are the vertebral arteries, and they run right up through that, and they actually contribute to the posterior part of the circle of Willis. Right, they fuse together, and they become the basilar artery, and they feed into the posterior part of the circle of Willis. Over here, you can actually see the ventral ramus. Over here is the dorsal ramus. This is actually going to be the dorsal root ganglion, which consists of a lot of your unipolar neurons, right? And over here, you can actually see some of the fibers that are coming into the, specifically, this is actually going to be the ventral ramus. So these are the fibers that are coming out of the anterior gray horn of the spinal cord. See, these are the somatic nerves that are coming out of the, specifically the ventral gray horn. They'll go out to supply skeletal muscles. These are going to be the fibers back here. These yellow fibers are going to be the fibers that are taking sensations from, again, the periphery, bringing it through this dorsal root ganglion right here, which is where a lot of unipolar neurons are, our first order neurons and stuff. It's going to take it in through this and into these fibers here and into the posterior gray horn. So again, dorsal root ganglion, this is actually going to be some of the fibers coming off. It'll go into what's called the ventral ramus, and some of it can go out the dorsal ramus. And again, this is the dorsal root ganglion with the unipolar neurons. And this is going to be the fibers that are feeding into the dorsal gray horn of the spinal cord. And again, these are fibers coming from the ventral gray horn of the spinal cord. All right, ninja nerds, I hope all of this made sense. I really hope it helped. And until next time.